So when we talk about the importance of trace elements, we need to talk about majority of the trace elements which we consume as a regular diet. So one such trace element is molybdenum, probably which you have not heard before or probably don't know much about it. So here I am talking about molybdenum. So molybdenum is a natural soil particle which is found and is absorbed through plants. So basically from the northern Gangetic plains to down south of red soil, you have different types of soils which you come across. So locally you have different food particles which is available, and if you consume those local food, your body has that much amount of molybdenum. So having said that, you need to understand that because plants absorb molybdenum from the soil, some plants are rich in molybdenum and some plants are not rich in molybdenum. So whether you need molybdenum or not is the question which we need to answer. So definitely you need at least 35 to 45 micrograms every day. So you don't get a free molybdenum per se. How you get it is in the form of molybdenum chloride or sodium molybdate or molybdenum glycinate or molybdenum amino acid chelate. So you derive this from legumes, plants, grains and nuts. So when we think about its importance in our body, we need to understand that molybdenum is basically absorbed freely through intestine and it circulates throughout the blood and pumped out of urine. But what exactly is the function of molybdenum is it helps in oxidizing of sulfite or oxidizing of aldehyde, oxidizing of xanthan, and also as a removal of the toxin byproducts due to the process of metabolites. So when we say oxidization, it's basically converting sulfite into sulfate, preventing the sulfite buildup. We'll talk about what happens when a lot of sulfate is being seen in the body. Along with that, it breaks down aldehyde, which is a very toxic to the body, helps in buildup of alcohol in the system due to some drugs or consumption of alcohol. So basically aldehyde reduces in the presence of molybdenum. Similarly, xanthan is converted into uric acid. This breaks down the nucleotides, and also this helps in further processing of uric acid into the urine. So basically anything which is happening in your system, which is the last mile of removing, you need molybdenum to convert them safely so that it can be transferred to other parts of the body. So that is the reason why molybdenum is not seen much, because people don't understand that everything is essential in the body, not just the consumption but also excretion. So it takes care of your liver, it takes care of your metabolite or metabolic after effects, and also in presence of a good healthy environment, your urine can also be cleared off without much of a trouble. So why is this required? So the important thing which we talk about molybdenum is in conversion of or oxidation of the byproducts. So basically sulfites are found in your preservatives and artificial sweeteners or artificial foods. So they are high in sulfites, which is used as a preservative. So this leads to reduced allergic reactions in future. Along with that, this helps in treating of arthritis as well as certain type of cancers. Recent researchers have also shown a positive growth in neuropsychotic disorders because of the DNA synthesis and breakdown successfully out of the system. But a deficiency of molybdenum is not seen much because molybdenum is freely available in plants. But if you just try to avoid giving any source of molybdenum to the body, there has been seen a little bit of encephalopathy and seizures. But this is not so true because majority of the food which you eat do contain a little bit amount of or a trace amount of molybdenum as well. But let's assume that you are a heavy drinker, is more in your system. Then you think about having supplementation in form of molybdenum. You need to understand molybdenum is not just aldehyde reducing agent, but also it helps in building up the uric acid in your body. So that leads to gout-like syndrome in your joints. And unfortunately, like any other chemistry, molybdenum takes the help of copper to reduce itself up. So once it starts reducing itself up, the copper's trace elements in the body reduces, thus leading to lower copper in your body, which is required for much more faster effect in your system. So we will talk about copper in the next presentation. So this is what it is about molybdenum. So don't worry about the deficiency or the toxicity until you are having it naturally found in your system. So if you have thinking of a lot of food which you take it as a preservative, So probably you need to start binging more on fruits and vegetables also, along with nuts and grains. So that balances out the additional intake of preservatives in the form of sulfites. Then you can make sure that your body is healthy enough to absorb the additional sulfites which is coming through these preservatives. So having said that, this is Dr. Aditya signing off. Meet you in the next video for the copper deficiency and other trace elements. Hang on to it. Subscribe to the channel for the next coming weeks, which we will be talking about more of the simple elements which is essential for our day-to-day activity. See you around. Take care. Bye.